Google Forms is a simple way to create and manage online forms. Many users choose it because they are familiar with other Google products and their interface. On top of all of that, it's free, which makes it very competitive. On the other hand, while it's great for individuals, it may not be ideal for bigger things. I'm Sabina, a content manager at Survicate. Today we'll talk about Google Forms pros and cons and four other tools you might want to consider for feedback collection. What is Google Forms good at? Google Forms is a free survey builder that is easy to use. You can make unlimited forms with unlimited questions and add links to images and videos. There's a limited library with about 16 basic templates like job application, customer feedback, or event registration. But Google Forms' biggest advantage is that response data is fed directly into Google Sheets. But not everyone realizes that this is far from a unique selling proposition. Most survey builders are successfully integrated with Google Sheets, including some of the alternatives we'll talk about today. So what's wrong with just using Google Forms? Google Forms has very limited design and customization. All of their forms look the same. Another common criticism is that their analysis features are very limited. For example, you can't filter or sort data by basic factors like dates and responses. What's more, you can't embed Google Forms in emails or in your app. You can embed forms on Google Sites, but the usability is very limited. Most forms simply have to be sent by link that takes respondents to an external URL. All in all, Google Forms is suitable for individuals who, for example, want to conduct some research during their studies. You may get away with using Google Forms for in-house feedback. But if you have other business purposes, you might quickly run into a glass ceiling. Let's have a look at some tools designed for feedback collection on a larger or more comprehensive scale. Survicate. Survicate is a great tool for surveys and personalized questionnaires. You can create and distribute forms, analyze results, and keep track of important metrics, all in one place. Survicate offers sophisticated customization options, so instead of all your forms looking like this, or like this, they can look a bit more like this, or even like that. You can also send surveys via four different channels. Choose email and link surveys to share them on social media or embed them into your emails. You can also have website surveys that you can target to show up on specific pages or after specific events. There are app surveys that can show up on particular screens or after particular interactions. And there are intercom surveys that can show up right inside the intercom chat. Survicate has a handy survey creator that lets you choose from many professionally designed templates. You can also create surveys from scratch. Reviews praise the tool's ease of use and setup. And to provide an even more well-rounded experience, Survicate offers a great set of one-click integrations. Thanks to them, you can, for example, tag the right team member to act on customer feedback via Microsoft Teams, reach out to customers via intercom, or send email campaigns with MailChimp. Survicate's features are constantly updated and maintained. This ensures customers receive ongoing high-level experiences. And yes, you can export Survicate survey results into Google Sheets in real time. But with our interactive survey report, you likely won't have to. Microsoft Forms. Microsoft Forms is an enterprise alternative to Google Forms. This is a web-based app available on all platforms and browsers as part of the Microsoft 365 suite. The program is used for both educational and professional settings, as well as for personal use. The Microsoft interface is modern and also provides appealing dynamic themes. Its main features include skip logic and branching, which are a lot more sophisticated than what is offered by Google Forms. While Microsoft Forms are clutter-free, new users might find it confusing. It's also worth noting that users cannot save unfinished forms or modify their responses after submitting them. This raises the risk of inaccurate data as users cannot fix their mistakes, and you'll also miss out on partial responses. Overall, it's a good Google Forms alternative, but not a perfect one. It's best suited for those who are already on Microsoft 365. And there is no free plan unless you already subscribe to the Microsoft suite. Jotform. With Jotform, you can create powerful surveys that are a good alternative to Google Forms. Their advanced design features make it one of the leading online form builders. The tool is easy to set up, even for beginners. You can integrate many tools with this solution, and there's a great deal of templates and question types. You can even create payment forms with their many payment gateways. On the other hand, Jotform is quite expensive when you take into account how many features are only available on the highest subscription tiers. Jotform offers a free plan with 5 forms and 100 monthly submissions. ClickUp. ClickUp is a powerful project management tool and customer feedback solution. ClickUp offers all kinds of productivity features. In many ways, from task management to tracking targets, it is primarily designed to streamline collaboration and make team members work easier. That's why creating forms is just one of the many features available in ClickUp. It deserves to be mentioned as an alternative to Google Forms, thanks to its extensive features. It provides custom fields such as date, location, checkbox, or even phone number. In addition, users can customize a thank you message that appears after a form is submitted. On the downside, upgrades don't happen too often, and they're probably not among the company's main priorities. The navigation can sometimes be tricky, and mastering it does take a little digging. Overall, surveys are a great addition to ClickUp if you are already using the tool for product management. However, you may find it's a bit too complex if you're using it for forms only.